Yes, we're bored. We're all bored now. But has it ever occurred to you, Wally, that the process that creates this boredom that we see in the world now may very well be a self-perpetuating, unconscious form of brainwashing created by a world totalitarian government based on money, and that all of this is much more dangerous than one thinks? And it's not just a question of individual survival, Wally, but that somebody who's bored is asleep, and somebody who's asleep will not say no. See, I keep meeting these people. I mean, just a few days ago, I met this man who I greatly admire, a Swedish physicist, Gustav Bjornstrand, and he told me that he no longer watches television, he doesn't read newspapers, and he doesn't read magazines. He's completely cut them out of his life because he really does feel that we're living in some kind of Orwellian nightmare now, and that everything that you hear now contributes to turning you into a robot.
On to somebody, they read what you're saying, and then they are re-experienced, and that's the only connection you have with that man. So you can't rewrite, because to rewrite is to deceive and lie, and you betray your own thoughts. To rethink the flow and the rhythm and the tumbling out of the words is a betrayal. It's a sin, Martin. It's a sin.
I don't accept your Catholic interpretation of my compulsive necessity to rewrite every single word at least 100 times. Guilt is the key, not sin. Guilt re not writing the best that I can. Guilt re not considering everything from every possible angle, balancing everything.
Well, how about guilt re censoring your best thoughts, your most honest, primitive, real thoughts? Because that's what your laborious rewriting amounts to, Martin.
Is rewriting really censorship, Bill? Because I'm completely fucked if it is.
Exterminate all rational thought. That is the conclusion I have come to.
What is the man talking about? I'm being serious.
So is he.
think so, dear.
It's the corn legs lover and you come out. Taste the heart of the corn. A great part of the corn.
If I did have these before, I like them.
Feel alone right now.
I'm
I mean, I'd like to believe I'm not, but I've just never seen any proof, so I just don't debate it anymore, you know? It's like, I could spend my whole life debating it over and over again, weighing the pros and cons, and in the end, I still wouldn't have any proof, so I just don't debate it anymore. It's absurd.
The search for God is absurd.
It is if everyone dies alone.
Does that scare you?
I don't want to be alone.
Anymore, it's all automated. What are we for then? We're consumers. Okay, buy a lot of stuff, you're a good citizen. But if you don't buy a lot of stuff, if you don't, what are you then, I ask you? What? Mentally ill. Back, Jim, back. If you don't buy things, toilet paper, new cars, computerized blenders, electrically operated sexual devices, stereo systems with brain implanted headphones, screwdrivers, miniature built-in radar devices, voice activated computers.
Thank you. 趣味なんだ。寝てて。
寝すぎだぞ。人生の半分以上は夢の中だぜ。
そうよ。でも寝るのって最高。死んだらもう眠れないし、夢だって見られなくなっちゃう。
Disassociating myself from reality more and more each day. I'm antisocial. I'm becoming dangerously amoral. I've lost the ability to distinguish between right from wrong, good from bad. I'm scared, Mom. I feel like sometimes I'm plunging headfirst into something.Black void of sheer utter madness or something.
Do you want a sandwich?
No, thanks.
There's a little egg salad left in the refrigerator. I mean, really, it's no trouble.
No, really, I'll get my own dinner tonight. Thank you.
Okay.
I enjoy chaos and disorder. Not just because they help me professionally.They're also my hobby. You see, I'm an entropy fan. I'm an entropy fan. When I first heard of entropy in high school science, I was attracted to it immediately. When they told me that in nature, all systems are breaking down, I thought, what a good thing. What a good thing. Perhaps I can make some small contribution in this area myself. And of course, it's not just in nature. In this country, the whole social structure just beginning to collapse. You watch. Just beginning now.Apart the edges and the seams. And the thing I like about that is that it means it makes the news on television more interesting, makes the television news more exciting, makes it more fun. I watch television news for one thing and one thing only, entertainment. That's all I want from the news, entertainment. You know my favorite thing on television? Bad news. Bad news and disasters and accidents and catastrophes. I want to see some explosions and fires. I want to see shit blowing up and bodies flying around. I'm not interested in the budget.I don't care about tax negotiations. I don't want to know what country the fucking Pope is in. But You show me a hospital that's on fire and people on crutches are jumping off the roof and I'm a happy guy! See a tornado in a church on Sunday. I want to see people. I want to know there's some guy running through the Kmart with an automatic weapon firing at the clerks. I want to see thousands of people in the street killing policemen. I want to hear about a nuclear meltdown. I want to know the stock market dropped 2,000 points in one day. I want to see people under pressure. Sirens, flames, smoke, bodies, graves being filled, parents weeping, exciting shit, my kind of TV. I just want some entertainment. It's just the kind of guy I am. It's the kind of guy I am. You know what I love the most? When big chunks of concrete and fiery wood are falling out of the sky and people are running around trying to get out of the way. Exciting shit. That's why I watch auto racing. That's the only reason I watch auto racing. I'm waiting for some accidents, man. I want to see some cars on fire. I don't care about a bunch of redneck jack-offs driving 500 miles in a circle. 500 miles in a circle? Children can do that, for Christ's sake. Doesn't impress me. I want to see some schmuck with his hair on fire running around punching his own head, trying to put it out. I want to see the pits explode. I want to see a car doing a 200-mile-an-hour cartwheel. Hey, where else besides auto racing am I going to see a 23-car collision and not be in the son of a bitch? And if a car flies out of control, lands in the stands and kills 50 spectators, fine. Fuck them. Serves them right. They paid to get in. Let them take their chances with everybody else. Just means more fun for me. More fun for me. Hey, at least I admit it. At least I admit it. Most people won't admit to those feelings. Most people see something like that on television and say, oh, isn't that awful? Isn't that too bad? Lying asshole. Lying asshole. You love it and you know it. Explosions are fun. And hey, the closer the explosion is to your house, the more fun it is. Sometimes you have the TV on and you're working around the house. Some guy comes on television and says, 6,000 people were killed in an explosion today. You say, where, where? He says, in Pakistan. You say, oh, fuck Pakistan. Too far away to be any fun. But if he says it happened in your hometown, you'll say, whoa, hot shit. Come on, Dave, let's go look at the bodies. Let's go look at the bodies. I love bad news. I love bad news. Hey, the more bad news there is, the faster this system collapses. Fine by me, fine by me. Don't bother my ass, don't bother my ass, none. I'm glad the water sucks. I'm glad it sucks. You know what I do about it? I drink it.
forget it.
Thank you.
I think I could turn and live with animals. They are so placid and self-contained. They do not lie awake in the dark and weep for their sins. They do not make me sick discussing their duty to God. Not one of them kneels to another or to his own kind that lived thousands of years ago. Not one of them is respectable or unhappy. All over the earth.
5. The earthly paradise is just like it was before. Better, in fact, because the coddled, well-fed animals now seem to have lost the violent instincts they had in that other Eden, created by the sanguinary god of the Old Testament. Man, in his anxious search for a world without dangers and surprises, is deceived for a moment and thinks he has achieved his aim.
Interesting. I do so enjoy observing the flora and fauna of that tiny planet. I think man is the most interesting insect on Earth, don't you? There is a growing tendency to think of man as a rational thinking being, which is absurd. There is simply no evidence of any intelligence on the Earth.
Thank you. realize the curvature of the earth for the first time. You're the first man to ever look at the planet he's from. And he's lost in that moment. And then all of a sudden, this strange ticking. It's coming out of the dashboard.
Okay, yeah.
Rips out the control panel, right? Takes out his tools, trying to find the sound, trying to stop the sound. But he can't find it. He can't stop it. It keeps going. A few hours into this, begins to feel like torture. A few days go by with the sound, and he knows that this small sound will break him. He'll lose his mind. What's he gonna do? He's up in space, alone, in a space closet. He's got 25 days left to go with this sound. So Cosmonaut decides the only way to save his sanity is to fall in love with this sound. So he closes his eyes. And he goes into his imagination. And when he opens them, he doesn't hear ticking anymore. He hears music.
nerve connections were blocked and infiltrated and atrophied, so the brain couldn't give orders anymore. It was trapped inside the skull, sealed off. For a while, you could see the silent, helpless suffering of the brain behind the eyes. And then finally, the brain must have died because the eyes went out. And there was no more feeling in them than a crab's eye at the end of a stalk.
Has been disintegrating. I spent too much time on the other side. Now it's eating away at my mind, erasing what's left of it. My memories are all confused, slowly self-destructing, fading like a dream when you wake up.